host, no introductions, silence. Slight poet leads over to Capital P. Poet, asks, the fuck is this? Capital P. Poet rolls his eyes, says, oh, just another slam poet. He morphs into Leslie Knope, says, anything can be a slam poem. If you say it like this, it's pointless. He says, that's not the way things are done here. Says, we have dead white men, I need rules to follow. Capital P. Poet says, they're gonna spit a new piece. So slam poet follows the rules she knows, calls out, new shit. Says what? And then waits for slam poet to explain. All eyes are on slam poet, and she buries herself in the shame of stealing focus because she knows how important opportunities are to share your story no matter the theme. Capital P. Poet says we are silent out of respect, but slam poet knows that maybe not all respect looks the same. She always respects the mic, but does so by being vocal. Asks, what if the snap really means I see you? Or what if a clap is code for, I will use these hands to hold the pieces of you together until all of your glue is dry. So Slam Poet says, fuck this prim and proper shit. We from the South and we will shout amen from the back. Yeah. And, yeah. And Slam Poets usually feel the spirit move, y'all. Yeah. Captain P. Poet says, oh good, another church poem. How original. Says, this is a sacred space. Asks, what could you possibly know of this kind of holy? But Slam Poet just smiles because she remembers stories of angels throwing entire parties when one single soul is saved, and she wonders what could be worth celebrating more than this. Wonders where on earth besides a slam someone could come for this kind of holy, the kind of holy where you need only touch the hem of the mic to be renewed. And Slam Poet expects a fucking party in this place. You see, Slam Poet knows that silence does not denote sacred. Knows that there are more than 50 scriptures that mention the sheer volume of praise. She wonders how the God whose voice is thunder feels about silence and thinks he'd rather be in a slam. Yeah. Thinks that Jesus would be a dope-ass poet, because yeah. What is a poet if not someone who breathes life into people? Yeah. The scripture says to weep with those who weep and rejoice with those who rejoice, and y'all, there's no way in hell that's quiet.
Yeah.
And there's nowhere else I'd rather do that shit than here. So blessed are the people who take this stage and share their stories for you to be healed. Blessed are the people who are brave enough to give us your energy to facilitate this kind of worship, for yours is the kingdom of community.